sky, stopping my shine. They try to break me, try to take me out, but I got Jesus on my side. I'm so glad I thought of the die. But ain't no power stronger than the one that came and laid down his life. And I got mountains to climb. The enemy can't stop me, cause there's a calling on my life. So when I'm crying, don't last too long, cause he gon' step in and make it alright. Only do it, he said he would. Fight your battles for you, they gon' wonder how you sleep at night. Only do it, oh yeah.
We Please continue to stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and the pledge to the Christian flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior, for whose kingdom it stands, risen, coming again, with life everlasting for all who believe. Please be seated.
So welcome parents and relatives, family, friends, teachers, faculty. We are here today to celebrate the graduating class of 2023. So we're gonna have a wonderful night together as we get to hear from students, get to hear from some staff, we get to worship together, turn tassels from right to left. We also get a chance to fellowship afterwards, so it's gonna be a wonderful time. But graduates, I'll just speak to you and say that we are so excited that this time has come. And it has been an honor to actually get to see you grow through the years. Some of you have just been here for a few years. Some of you have been here for as many as 14 years. So I've actually been able to see you grow from very short to now where I have to look up to some of you. But it's really been an honor, and especially just what your teachers and leaders have to say about you as disciples of Jesus Christ, that you truly are that. And as a disciple, you know, they have really seen you grow and have that commitment to want to follow Jesus 100% as your master. And that's what we exist for. We exist to make disciples of Jesus Christ and to prepare students to glorify God. And you have done that in the way you've walked things out. And that's not to say you've done it all perfectly. None of us have done that. But when you fell down, you got back up again to follow after him and to say, Jesus, I want to be like you. And that's what we're all about here. So we're excited tonight to be able to celebrate this time with you and look forward to the whole evening together. I want to invite Kimara Thermidor to come up and open us up in prayer at this time.
Please bow your heads in reverence as we begin to pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we gather here today in honor of the graduating class of 2023 and in celebration of all that you've allowed us to accomplish. We thank you for every single individual student here and for the unique gifts and talents that you've given us. We thank you for the staff and faculty at CCA and for the passion that you've given them to pour into the students and families here and the institution of Calvary. We thank you once again for just being here and just celebrating closing this chapter of our lives and stepping out into a new season. We pray that you move us in such a way that we are convicted and that we are reminded of your love, light, and truth daily, so that we might be doers of the word. And we thank you for just everything that you do, Lord, the things that we see, the things that we don't. And in your heavenly name we pray, amen.
Thank you, Kimara. Parents, family, and friends of CCA's class of 2023, welcome. Before I introduce you all to the graduating class, I want to take a moment to recognize and celebrate the teachers and leaders here in this room tonight. We would not be here tonight without their hard work and commitment. Here at CCA, our teachers fully recognize the calling that God has placed on their lives to be here, to be teacher ministers. And it is with joy that they serve each day to share their love for the subjects that they teach, their love for you as students, and their love for the Lord. When these three loves intersect and overlap, Your teachers find themselves in this incredible sweet spot of what God has called them to. And that's where your Christian worldview can truly and properly be formed. Class of 2023, family and friends, can we give the teachers and leaders in this room a big round of applause? And now to introduce the students. Students, class of 2023, you made it. This right here, this is truly, truly, truly it. It is the finish line of your K-12 experience. And what a joy it's been to watch you all grow, love, and lead. Guests, many of you here tonight are celebrating a specific one or maybe a few of the students who are set to walk across this stage in a short while. So I want to take a few minutes to introduce you all to this, the amazing class of 2023, so that you can more fully appreciate the awesome things that God has done. In and amongst this group of students, we have, and first some academic highlights, 98 students, almost half, in the National Honor Society. 114 students earned endorsements along with their diplomas, which means they took extra and challenging classes in the areas of STEM, world languages, fine arts, psychology, or ministry. We have 35 students that are AP scholars. We have 6 AP capstone diplomas earned tonight. We have 2 National Merit Commended students. We have a National Merit Finalist. We have an overall class GPA of 3.726. When it comes to service, there are a whopping sum total of 43,072 service hours completed by this class. That's an average of almost 220 per student over the course of just their 4 years of high school. We have students who have competed and succeeded at the highest levels of athletic, scholastic, fine arts, and robotics competitions. We have many individuals and teams or group who have earned district, regional, state, and national recognitions, awards, and titles. And the accolades could go on and on and on. But most importantly, we have a group of students before us who have been the hands and the feet and the heart of Jesus to one another and to a world around them that is in need. They've served in local schools. They've led in worship services both here and at schools and many local churches in the area. They've loved on mission and class trips both locally and far away. And as we've heard a lot over the past few weeks and even this year, they've started many group Bible studies, both here on campus and in some of your homes. And they've not only served and strengthened one another through these Bible studies, but they've set an example for the rest of the school to follow. And as we have seen, that example has been contagious. And that is the stuff that legacies are made of. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Calvary Christian Academy class of 2023. There are a few special groups to point out and recognize this evening. This year we have a large number of students, 38 to be exact, who've been continuously enrolled at CCA since kindergarten. Students, when you see your names on the screen, please stand, and we'll have 2 screens toggle back and forth. So stand to your feet. We have Isabel Alawart, Tyler Aspati, Cooper Aurelia, Cole Baird, Kayla Barnes, Brianne Bent, Xavier Bimbaro, Ava Camargo, Ryan Cavalancia, Katie Clausen, Caleb Coble, Kevin Calendris, Daniel Cuesta, Joshua Espinoza, Elizabeth Guerrero Tirado, Jessica Hansen, Katarina Hernandez, Sophia Kerrigan, Emma Kohlhepp, Taylor McMullen, David Metzger, Kaya Mills, Evangeline Naharo, Jonah Nelson, Eva Polio, Zoe Purdick, Luke Richardson, Adam Savarese, Sophia Silva, Tyler Stoller, Gabe Strike, Celeste Dressau, Joey Sudial, Caden Talbert, Mariana Urrutia, and Peter Vargas. Stay standing, you 38. And I thought about, you know, do I read all of those names? And I think the importance of reading all those names, and it's not just for you. There are many others who've been here for a long time. But as I read your names, your first and your last, that's a testament, and that's a testimony to you. That's a testament and a testimony to your families. So we want to say thank you for your 13 years, and some of you more, of dedication to the start to finish line experience. And thank you to your parents for entrusting your most precious gifts to us for all this time. You may be seated. Next, I want to recognize the top 10% of the class. Students, when you see your names on the screen, would you please rise? The top 10% of the class of 2023, Mario Awed, Caleb Barnes, Nicole Bello, Ava Camargo, Daniel Cuesta, Raquel De La Cruz Rodriguez, Faith Elwell, Hillary Foster, Taylor McMullen, Vanessa Miro, Naya Montez, Evangeline Naharo, Eva Polio, Thomas Poulos, Franco Ruaco, James Stone, Caden Talbert, Brianna Tully, Trinity Vandevender, and Ashlyn Vick. Ladies and gentlemen, believe it or not, but the average GPA of these 20 students is a whopping 4.436. Congratulations, students, to you for your year-in and year-out dedication and hard work. You may be seated. The next group is a special group. These are international students. So we have five who will be graduating tonight. When you see your picture on this first screen, would you please stand? We have Christopher Bojelin from Haiti. Crystal Wang from China. Frankie Xu from China. Orpha Noel from Haiti. And Juan Pablo Romero from Venezuela. Stay standing, you five, and joining you are three international students who have joined us for a year for a study abroad experience. Would you please stand? Alejandra Tavares from Mexico. Janine Monnier from Canada. And Alice Ragni from Italy. To you eight, we marvel at the courage that you have displayed in leaving all that you knew to study here in the United States. We recognize the great faith that your parents bestowed upon us as you students have lived in our homestay program and within our community. Unfortunately, I know that many of your parents are unable to travel here today, but we know that many of them are viewing through our online streaming. And to you parents that are watching online overseas, we celebrate you and your brave pioneers. And we are excited for their impact on the world for Christ. We're proud of their accomplishments and their hearts to both learn and share the gospel worldwide. Thank you for sending and for sharing your children with us. Students, you may be seated. Finally, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to draw your attention to the graduation program. A few pages in, there's a page labeled Distinctions that will help you identify the many and various areas where our graduates have achieved at high levels. Across from that page is labeled Honor Cord Distinction. That provides a visual depiction of the various cords earned by the students. We'll now shift gears to the next portion of the program, where three of our graduating seniors will be recognized for the commitments that they are making to serve our nation. Here to make these special presentations are Lieutenant Colonel Lee Speckler, Captain Benjamin Gutierrez and Staff Sergeant Sebastian Manitou. Please welcome them to the platform at this time.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for having me here. It is my privilege to represent the United States Air Force and Space Force to present an admittance to the United States Air Force Academy Preparation School, located on the grounds of the U.S. Air Force Academy in Colorado Springs, Colorado. This is the equivalent of a one-year full-ride scholarship at any top-tier college preparatory school. Our prep school is designed to further prepare a student both academically and militarily for admission to the U.S. Air Force Academy. During this next year, the cadet candidate will study math, English, science, and military history while participating in strenuous military training and athletic programs. Upon successful completion of the prep school program, he will have an opportunity to apply for admission to the U.S. Air Force Academy. If appointed to the academy, he will attend the full four-year program, earn a Bachelor of Science degree in his choice from 40 majors and minors, and will be commissioned as a second lieutenant in the U.S. Air Force or Space Force. And so on behalf of the Academy and Director of Admissions, I am pleased to offer admittance to the United States Air Force Academy Prep School Class of 2024 to Mr. Cole Baird.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Staff Sergeant Manitou, part of the United States Marine Corps, and all I'd like to do tonight is just congratulate Luca Braswell right here for being one of the few to go ahead and take the ultimate challenge, right, answering the nation's call. Here in July, Luca's gonna make his way for a 13-week vacation to Paris Island, where he'll undergo a transformation and become one of the few, the proud, a United States Marine. Thank you.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Captain Benjamin Gutierrez. I work down at Florida International University, ROTC. Tonight, I'm presenting a three-year scholarship to Liberty University on behalf of Army ROTC. Thomas is going to learn how to be a military officer, and he'll graduate after his time during ROTC as a second lieutenant in the United States Army. So on behalf...
Hi, my name is Gage, and I have been participating in the theater program here at CCA for the past 6 years.
My name is Dale DiAgostino, and my focus at Calvary for these past few years has been robotics.
Hi, my name is Daniel Lopez, and I play trumpet in the band.
Hi, my name is Isabel Alvar, and my gifting and focus at Calvary is dance.
My name is Carl Sharonfront, and I play basketball here at CCA.
Hi, my name is Isabella Leon, and I've been heavily involved in the fine arts here at CCA.
Hi, I'm Zoe Purdick, and I'm part of the discipleship program.
Hi, my name is Braylon Mittera, and I play volleyball at CCA.
Hi, my name is Daniel LaBoy, and my gift is filmmaking and storytelling.
The most impactful moment for me at CCA was when I was getting ready for a show, and it was right before, and I was extremely, extremely stressed. And I wasn't quite sure how I was going to do it. I had a ridiculous amount of lines. And Miss McCoy came up and talked to me before the show, and she prayed with me. And it was a peace that surpasses all understanding. She completely calmed me down for the performance. And I think that show was one of the best performances I've given at this school. And I don't think I could have done it without God.
So CCA has offered me not only lots of higher level classes like AP and honors courses, but it's also offered me the visual arts endorsement track, which has allowed me to grow and grow my skills as an artist and as a Christian artist, and just really allowed me to focus on my passion and on my gifting.
My most impactful God/spiritual moment at CCA was the Mexico mission trip, in which I got to serve with my friends overseas in Mexico and experience how others live outside of America. From this experience, I learned to be thankful for what I have. I also learned how good it feels when you serve others, getting to see smiles on faces as you help them, even for small, simple things.
I think one of the best moments at CCA would probably be going to States my junior year for volleyball and just being able to bond with some of my friends that I would never have thought I would got close to.
I would say hands down, the best moment for me with my friends here at CCA was my sophomore year, winning a state championship for the first time. It was my first time winning something as a group in any event prior to high school. And the emotions of everything just flooding through when that buzzer went off in that moment, it was just a surreal moment. And everything that we went through that year, me personally and as a team, made the moment feel even more special, and the guys that I had beside me.
Okay, so for teachers, they all just are here to support you at Calvary. Specifically, I had a dance teacher. She really helped me to realize that in everything, our focus is God. It's not just, oh, we're here to dance right now, or, oh, we're here to do math here. I really got the chance to show Jesus through dancing, and she just had this fire for the Lord that really inspired me to be on fire for the Lord, and so I thought that was really cool.
So the staff at Calvary has just really helped me to realize that it's okay not to be perfect. And what I mean by that is, you know, try your best in all that you do, but don't feel like you have to be perfect in it. Your best is great. The best that you can give is perfectly good enough, because if your heart is right in doing that, then you don't have to feel like you have to stress yourself out trying to be perfect. So they've just really shown me that it's okay just to do your best, and I think that's a really healthy way just to grow. And they've definitely shown me that through academics, through extracurricular, through everything, really.
One of the best moments I've had with my friends at CCA has been this year. A couple of my friends started doing worship in the mornings before school on Tuesdays, and it's just a really awesome moment where we get to gather together unprompted by teachers, and it's just like a moment where we can worship God and pray for our school and the generations to come. And it's really just encouraging to look around and see a community of people that are actively chasing God.
My favorite memory with my friends at Calvary was creating short films and movies, like for example the homecoming video, or for any other event. It was just super fun to create something while having so much fun doing it.
The best part about being at CCA for me was just being able to connect with my teachers. I think that's one thing that makes CCA really unique, is that the teachers actually care about you. I mean, my endorsement teachers have just like poured so much into me to help me grow, not only as an artist, but as a Christian.
Getting to go through the Keys trip, Bahamas, 9th grade retreat, 10th grade retreat, Mexico, even going back on both Bahamas and Mexico with my friends right now, being with the people I've grown up with, I've been able to grow spiritually and socially with them, and it's been a really cool opportunity.
I would say something that I learned here about God is how God touches everybody in a different type of way. I always thought there was one perspective of how he can affect people, because how he affected me, whether that's sports, whether that's a different type of field, like there's so much different ways he can affect people.
I feel like the teachers at CCA are more than teachers, and they're more friends and mentors who are people you could just talk to. And a time at CCA I really struggled was at the beginning of CCA, and I just went into my classes like closed-minded, and then after I came back from the Bahamas trip, it just opened up my eyes to see who I truly am.
So in 10th grade, I recognized that a common theme in a lot of teenagers and kids my age, and even through myself, where we were experiencing a lot of anxiety, you know, just as a class and as a grade. And I wanted to do something about that. So in 10th grade, I created a short film about anxiety and just how it affects people on the daily basis, and you know, how we could overcome it and how we could have a positive outlook moving forward.
One time that I struggled spiritually at CCA was definitely coming off of COVID and quarantine and just being isolated and not having like the encouragement that I needed to pursue God. And coming back from that, it was honestly really hard, and I struggled with a lot of apathy and I just didn't really care. But going to Pastor Schott's class and Mr. Most and Miss Dearden, they really helped just instill an urgency for me to chase God and to get replugged into the church and to chapel and stuff.
If I could give any advice to a class at CCA, I would just say to develop a real relationship with Jesus. Because once you develop that real relationship with Jesus, then you will just be, you'll be fulfilled in life. All your needs will be taken care of. And that doesn't necessarily mean that your life will be great and perfect all the time. Know that you can just depend on one thing for sure, and that's Christ.
To my fellow classmates, I urge us to stay strong in our faith as we continue onwards into this next phase of life. I pray that we'd all find churches and strong Christian communionship as we head off into our next phase.
And to the class of 23, I encourage you to hold on to the relationships you've built at CCA. Don't let them go, and cherish them as you move on to this next chapter of your life.
What I would say to you guys is just always stay unique, always stay yourself. And just, I think we've had a great time here, and let's close it out.
I have the honor of introducing the class of 2023's salutatorian, Thomas Poulos. During his 4 years at CCA in high school, he has taken 11 advanced placement courses and 5 dual enrollment courses. He earned the AP Capstone Diploma, AP Scholar with Distinction, and has served as the National Honor Society President. I ask those at CCA who have known him the best to describe Thomas, and here are some of the things that they have said. Mr. Gelati, his AP macroeconomics teacher, says, "Thomas has a sharp mind. His intellect and strong character will make us proud." AP US history teacher, Mr. Blatz, compared Thomas to the Protestant reformer Martin Luther, saying, "He is passionate about the gospel and the truth that salvation comes by grace alone, by faith alone, in Christ alone, as revealed by the scriptures alone, to the glory of God alone." Thomas models this so very well. Mrs. Cafaro, who taught him AP seminar, said, "Thomas is a hard worker. He gets along with everyone. He always provided comic relief during stressful times, which was much appreciated." Ms. Fox explained that in AP Lang, he had a knack for helping his classmates overcome struggles and for encouraging them to see the bright side of things, whether in or out of class. Additionally, Thomas is a quick but deep thinker, one who can handle the nuances and complexities of ideas well. Pastor Schott said his interaction with scriptures, both academically and practically, has served as a role model for his peers, day in and day out. Mrs. Shaver describes his presence in the classroom as one that creates an environment of focused learning mixed with a lot of laughter. Coach Sorg said that while academics come quite easily to him, He watched him persevere through nagging injuries and embrace being uncomfortable in order to be part of something bigger than himself. Coach Hoza praises his humility. Thomas's humility in returning to football after a year away and his commitment to put in the work necessary to catch up to his classmates led to on-field success and also contributed to his earning an ROTC scholarship. Hearing these words from his teachers and coaches really highlight the fact that Thomas has excelled at CCA spiritually and socially as well as academically. It is my honor to present our CCA Class of 2023 salutatorian Thomas Poulos.
Good evening, parents, faculty, staff, fellow students, and all friends and family. As already stated, my name is Thomas Poulos, and I am extremely grateful for being awarded this honor. I would first and foremost like to thank my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I would not be the man, son, brother, friend, or student I am today without him, and I fully attribute every gift and talent I have as being from him. To my parents, you have always expected excellence from me, but shown me love regardless of my failures, instilling that drive in me to do the best in all aspects of life. To my siblings, Nina, James, and Daniel, you all have shaped my personality and have helped fuel the fire to my competitive nature, sometimes to a fault, which has led to our mother taking routine trips to the ER. I thank the multitude of teachers and coaches that have put up with me over the past 4 years. There are so many loving, encouraging, endearing, and trustworthy teachers at this school, and I will forever be grateful for the time and effort they have poured into me, growing my fellow classmates and myself. I'll grab that after. Likewise, I've had numerous coaches who have put their all not only improving me as a football player, but as a man of God. Lastly, I would like to thank all my friends and fellow classmates. Every single one of you has added to my high school experience, and I could not have asked for a better graduating class. To my numerous friends, you have each influenced me in different ways. I'm surprised many of you have put up with me over the past 4 years, as I know I can be very strong-willed and stubborn, sometimes to a fault. My father sometimes laughs jokingly and tells me, I'm surprised you even have any friends. So to all of you I call friends, I'm greatly appreciative, and I'm excited to see what the future holds. So, as many highly motivated and academic students would, I found myself waiting until the last minute and writing this speech 2 nights ago. And as I scrambled to come up with a speech for you all tonight, I realized that I have a gold mine of meaningful family stories to tell. For those of you who do not know my family well, many consider us more than crazy. If you follow my mother's Facebook or Instagram, you would know this by the bizarre family stories she documents, usually involving my siblings and myself. But the story I will tell tonight focuses on my older brother and myself, the guy who screams, "That's my brother," while walking down. Now, while he claims I am telling a twisted version of this story, I told him that I am the one with the microphone tonight. If he wanted a chance to stand up here, he should have been smarter last year. Now, to the children in the audience, please do not try what I say at home. Me and my brothers like to think of ourselves as trained professionals. A little over a year ago, I found myself in the kitchen with my older brother. It was about 10 o'clock on a Sunday night, and I had math homework due at midnight that had been assigned for over 2 weeks. While I should have been doing my math homework, I looked up at my brother and thought, how can I best annoy him? Being his brother, this came naturally to me. So I looked around and my gaze fell upon the rather new set of Cutco kitchen knives poised on the counter. I waltzed over to the knife block and unsheathed the largest one. I wielded my new big sharp toy in ninja fashion and wasn't really surprised when he forcibly disarmed me with his superior strength. But I was not to be denied. Laughing and dueling like pirates, I attempted to
lightly graze his arm. Now, while my brother claims to be the victim, I still believe he purposely moved his arm into the blade. So who is really at fault is still up for debate. Regardless of fault, it was not the light graze I intended, but rather a deeper gash. So I did what any younger brother would do. I threw him a band-aid, said good luck, and went to finish my math assignments. A few minutes later, my mother walked into the room, and although she was shocked by the scene, she just shook her head and said, "Why do I even get surprised anymore?" The next day, my brother ended up needing 5 stitches. Now, you are all probably sitting there wondering why I am telling the story of how I outdueled my older brother in the kitchen. And although part of the reason is to share a rather lighthearted and funny story, the purpose is to show everyone that I am human too, and I make stupid, boneheaded mistakes. Although I may stand up here as salutatorian, I too make very foolish decisions. My mother likes to refer to me, and I quote, as the dumbest smart kid she knows. The reason I say all this is to show each and every one of you, regardless of our achievements, at the end of the day, we are all imperfect humans. We are taught by the age of 5 not to play with knives. And here my older brother and I were, ages 19 and 17, playing with knives in the kitchen. Although we were not trying to seriously harm each other, we realized when we toy around with dangerous objects, accidents happen. We all in life will be making mistakes that we later on regret or look back on wondering, what on earth were we thinking? But I want you all to remember that we shouldn't pin our failures to our identity. Scripture tells us in Isaiah 43:18, forget the former things, do not dwell on the past. My classmates and I are entering a new stage of our lives in which the world will want to point out every mistake we make and use those to try and draw us further away from Christ. The challenge we will all face is not whether or not we will overcome them. We are bound to mess up, but our mistakes won't define us. Our responses will. The charge I want to leave my classmates with is not to expect perfection. We will make mistakes. Rather, after we make those mistakes, we should focus on God to learn from them, instead of letting the world and sinful nature take control. So to my fellow seniors, I would like to leave you with a poem, which I have heard numerous times from Coach Hoza. It is titled, The Road Not Taken by Robert Frost. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry I could not travel both, and be one traveler long I stood, and looked down as far as I could, to where it bent in the undergrowth. Then took the other as just as fair, and having perhaps the better claim, because it was grassy and wanted wear. Though as for that, the passing there had warned them really about the same. And both that morning equally lay, and leaves no step had trodden black. Oh, I kept the first for another day. Yet knowing how way lead on to way, I doubted if I should ever come back. I shall be telling this with a sigh, somewhere ages and ages hence. Two worlds diverge in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. So I urge you all, when push comes to shove between your faith and the world, take the path less traveled by, or as Matthew 7:14 puts it, take the narrow road that leads to life. Thank you, and may God bless you all, and go Flames.
A hard act to follow. It's my great pleasure to introduce the Calvary Christian Academy Class of 2023 valedictorian, Daniel Cuesta. Daniel attended CCA for 13 years and Calvary Chapel, Fort Lauderdale, his whole life. One of Daniel's motivational sayings is, as a Christian, we are called to be the best in everything we do. Therefore, as a Christian, he did not want to be mediocre. In middle school, he dreamed of one day becoming the valedictorian of his high school class. Mission accomplished. Daniel's final weighted GPA is 4.563. He scored a 1400 on his SAT. He took 16 AP and DE classes and 11 honors classes. Dr. Mack told me that Daniel is extremely intentional and goal-oriented, confident, bold, ultimately giving the glory to God for his success. And after passing of his father, Daniel has implemented these lessons from his father to be a young man who is indeed carrying on his father's legacy. Mrs. Womble reported that Daniel is our Silver Knight nominee in general scholarship category. His Silver Knight project demonstrates his tenacity and the lengths he will go to find the best solutions to ways to help others. He traveled across the pond, as they say, to England to meet with people developing creative methods using Legos to meet the needs of special needs children. Dr. Roselnix said that during AP research class, Daniel earned an international reputation as a scholar in the area of autism research, reaching out to and continuing to build relationships with renowned scholars and leaders around the world. However, even with this success, he remained humble. Daniel is an affirming, compassionate young man. In chemistry, his teacher, Mrs. Burnett, described that she had the privilege of teaching Daniel during the most difficult time of his life. And he remained academically faithful, spiritually hopeful, and continued to have a kind of generous spirit towards others in the midst of a life-changing trial he was going through at the time. He was faithful and unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. Finally, his Bible teacher, Mr. Schott, explained that Daniel is one of the most overall exceptionally gifted and well-rounded students I have taught over the past 27 years. He is musically gifted as he carried out his father's legacy as a talented, multifaceted entertainer who enjoys working hard with the gifts that God has given him. Academically gifted, Daniel uses his advanced intellect to master as much material with a comprehensive understanding that enriches his love and adoration of all that God's world has to discover. Spiritually gifted, Daniel uses his love for God and his son, Jesus Christ, to pour out of him all that have been poured into him, loving people with a selfless love that is most often sacrificial for Daniel. Yet, he offers himself with the strength of a much more seasoned saint, despite his youth. Socially gifted, Daniel has created and maintained friendships that are mutually enriching and spiritually supporting one another. What is Daniel's immediate future? He has accepted an offer from the University of Notre Dame College of Arts and Letters. With this, in hopes of becoming a public speaker and sharing his love of the Lord with others. Congratulations, Daniel, our 2023 CCA valedictorian.
Thank you, and all glory to God. Dear class of 2023, parents, faculty, and friends, you know what's really funny? I spent the last 2 weeks writing a series of speeches that I won't be sharing with you tonight. It took me a while to realize, but they weren't for tonight's celebration. Instead, I want to tell you a story. Today, my aim is point it all back to God. What better way to do that than show you where I've seen him in my own life? For example, before I was born, doctors found I had a hole in my heart. Miraculously, it closed. When born, my parents discovered I had a speech impediment. I was tongue-tied. In both these cases, I've seen the healing hand of God, and it was clear that he was at work from the beginning. At the age of 5, I joined Calvary and had the most lovely time until, you guessed it, middle school. It was in the 6th grade, and a good friend, coach of mine, came up to me and said, "Daniel, you're in shape, the shape of a muffin." And while maybe those weren't his exact words, I am very grateful to Mr. Del Busto for pushing me to join the cross-country team. On the team, I spent the next 5 years of my life becoming a leader, developing diligence, determination, and brotherhood. Some people call runners crazy, and I wouldn't disagree. But I would say that cross-country and the people the Lord led me through it truly taught me the importance of discipline, of getting back up after you've fallen, of always holding your head on high. In the middle of that season, I also began to read the book of Proverbs. I began to search out wisdom. If you haven't tried it yet, I highly recommend, for God gives wisdom generously to those who ask for it. In 10th grade, I decided to retire, per se, from cross country and embark on another learning adventure, the robotics team, further sharpening my life principles and the things already learned. And then, oh, there's my senior year. Well, that passed in a blink of an eye. All high school seemed like the slowest yet fastest 4 of my entire 18. Day in and day out, I implemented everything I've learned over the years. For I knew I had a goal, a vision, to be standing before you all tonight, speaking life. I was taught to rise early instead of staying up late. I was encouraged to find time to rest. I learned the study techniques that worked for me. But most importantly, I was led to be a tortoise among a world of hares. I will never forget that fable. My mama read it to me in kindergarten, and to this day she reminds me, "Danny, no matter how many times you read the story, the tortoise always wins." And boy, was she right. There's something about delayed gratification, the act of putting in work now for a greater harvest later. It's a principle I live by, found in Hebrews 12:11. That says, "No discipline seems pleasant at the time, but painful. Later on, however, it produces a harvest of righteousness and peace for those who have been trained by it." You think by now I'd have that memorized, right? That I can never forget it? Well, I can't explain it, but there's something funny when you see that girl you like, and oh, you get nervous. Imagine this. Let me set the stage. I'm preparing to leave campus, and after school, I happen to run into this lovely girl. My hands begin to shake. I feel the sweat forming on my brow. I start to overthink whether I should or shouldn't wear my glasses. Should I talk to her? I'd have you know, I did. I went up, and she was very, very kind. We talked about nothing too complex, but somehow or another, I was reminded of this verse. I went to share it with her. So I go to open my mouth, and nothing came out. I close it again, and I said, "Come on, Daniel, you live this word. Remember, remember, Hebrews 12:11. I cough, I try and buy some time. And then I say the most watered-down version of this verse I have ever heard. I go, "Whatever you do now will be worth it later, basically." I was so embarrassed, I couldn't believe myself. "Whatever you do now will be worth it later. Whatever happened to the discipline and harvest of righteousness?" What I'm trying to say is, none of us are perfect, and that's okay. We all get nervous sometimes, we all fall down. Just remember to look up when on your knees. Perhaps you noticed there was one milestone I skipped during that narrative. I thought it best to save. COVID-19, the pandemic that panicked and plagued us for almost 2 years. It changed everything from how close we could stand to each other to the amount of people actually paying attention in class. Strangely enough, there also seemed to be a correlation with increased Netflix use during that time, but I'm sure the class of 2023 had nothing to do with that. Speaking of the class of 2023, what a class it is and what a class we are. Think about everything we've done to everything we've gone through. We are a class like no other. In the words of some of the teachers themselves, we are their favorite. And that's something to be proud of. This class is known for loving one another and those around them. And so I ask, do you remember when you loved and gathered around me? For almost 2 years ago, on August 22nd, 2021, my father, Mario J. Cuesta, died from a massive heart attack that arose from complications of the COVID-19 virus. It was just as school had begun to reopen for its regular programming. After receiving the positive test results, our family engaged in prayer and all the Colombian homemade remedies we knew. But a week later, my father ended up in a hospital room and we weren't allowed to see him until it was too late. My mother stayed on the phone that last night. I woke up early and got to say, I love you, see you in a bit. I put on his wedding ring, hoping to give it to him the next time I saw him, but to this day, I still wear it. I wish that was a good stopping point, but guess what? I realize I'm still very much a young adult and still very much have young adult problems. When my grief came, my heart also wanted to pursue love, and I realized I was dealing with two ends of the emotional spectrum. No matter which way I leaned, my heart wasn't satisfied, and I experienced a time in my life where it felt like the world was falling apart. And maybe it was. But you know what's so beautiful about God? He loves you too much to leave you in your brokenness. It took time and effort, but bit by bit, I confronted my grief and began to heal. Some say grief is a never-ending journey, and while I don't know that, I can say God walks it with you. To this day, I deal with the whys and the can't be's consistently. I come face to face with the fact that my father is not here tonight to see me graduate. Yet despite that, I face you. It's begun to settle in that he won't be standing by my side to see me be married to my cherished, beloved, whoever she may be. I try to imagine him holding my children in his hands. I see his tender smile as he looks down on my babies and they smile back up at him. But these are things that are not and cannot be. Nonetheless, I am grateful for what God has given me. So how'd you do it? How'd you get back up? There's no pretty answer, but maybe Jesus says it best. In Luke 9:23, when he says, if anyone desires to come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross daily. I face the very things that were scary, the very things that led me to my lowest. The other day, I was speaking with mentor and pastor Javin Shashadi, and he looked me in the eyes and said, Daniel, when you go off to college, you can't take your friends, you can't take your parents, you can't take your teachers, but you can take your Bible. Is your Bible on your packing list, class of 2023? Maybe it's something we haven't thought about, but it's something we can't forget. It's part of the cross we bear, and without it, we wouldn't know how to. The thing is, and you may have noticed, I skipped the thank yous, and this is a point where I say I couldn't have done it alone, which is why I must first say thank you to the one who has made it all possible, the one who sustains us when we are worn and gives us strength when we are weak, to my Lord God, Jesus Christ. I must give thanks and glory. I am humbled by how far he has brought me, brought us. As Psalm 9:1 reads, I will give thanks to you, Lord, with all my heart. I will tell of your wonderful deeds. Tonight is a testament of all God's wonderful deeds, and so I give thanks. Being thankful is innate to the being that the Lord wants us to become, so I encourage you tonight to also be in a mindset of gratitude. Demonstrate your thankfulness to those who have stood by you, stood their ground, or perhaps even stood in your way to protect you or keep you from becoming distracted and losing focus on what really matters. With that said, my parents are my greatest support, inspiration, and source of discipline. My father, a man of God, the one who made me who I am and taught me what it means to be a future husband, a pursuer of God's heart. Thank you for instilling in me the virtues of a husband, even though you will never see me become one. I'm eternally grateful for the compassion with which I was raised and the love you never shied from showing me. Gracias, papi, te amo. And just as my father is a man of God, so too is my mother a woman of the Lord. My mother is beyond a shadow of a doubt my number one fan, role model, and confidant. Thank you for never letting me settle for anything less than who God has called me to be. My mother is the most extraordinary person in my world and brightens up my life daily. She's a beautiful woman of Proverbs 31, strong, courageous, and blessed. Gracias, mami. Te amo. Thank you to mi tata, mi abuela, for always showing everyone you meet a picture of me. Thank you to mis tíos, uncle and aunt, and primos, cousins, for showing me the importance of a good steak and a good laugh. Gracias a mis abuelos, my grandparents, for passing on the love of cooking to my father, as well as a love for music. I'm proud to be a fourth generation musician. To mi familia. Thank you to everyone who walks side by side with me, demonstrating who Christ is. Gracias por ser parte de mi tribu. Thank you for being a part of my tribe. So class of 2023, I say this to you, be grateful for those around you. And remember to look up when down, to confront the things that scare you, have the conversations you've been avoiding. But that very class, I ask this, do you realize the moment we throw these caps in the air, we've now become the class of 2027? And how incredible would it be to start building that legacy in this moment? To be a group of Jesus followers that grows in wisdom, that has diligence, determination, kindness, and always remembers that its help comes from the Lord. You see, you might forget my name. You might forget tonight. But remember that God will never forget you. And if there's one thing that I wish for you to take away tonight, it's this. Look up. Look up when you feel peer pressured. Look up when on the mountaintop. Look up when in the trial. Look up when you feel broken. Look up when you feel perfect. Look up to God. Life is coming in a way it never has before, and my prayer is you will turn to your Savior in those moments. Let us lift our eyes to the hills. Where does our help come from? Our help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. Class of 2023, let us always look up to God. In him we have our victories. Thank you, and may the Lord bless you greatly.
I think this is what Jesus imagined, what he dreamed when he told his first disciples, go into all the world and make disciples. And we are recipients of that unbroken chain of men and women who have followed Jesus, who invested in the next generation and the next generation, and that's the dream of CCA, and that's what you're witnessing here. And I want to let you know that that dream doesn't just affect kids. It also affects parents. It also affects our teachers. I've been here as a staff member for 23 years. And I've grown in my relationship with Jesus because of you and you and you. And after we worship together, we're going to hear from one of the best of us, Pastor Steve Mayo, who came here 15 years ago thinking, what is CCA and what is Calvary Chapel? And we've watched him in so many roles. He was at first that cool history teacher, that great service host with the gift of rap, and then a pastor and a discipleship director who has invested in thousands of young people. In class of 2023, as you take your leap of faith and you move on, he's also taken his leap of faith as he moves to Philly to reach back from the city he came from and invest in young people who don't have the same privilege as you do, to pour out his life. And he and his wife Morgan and their three sons are going to live that go and make disciple faith. But now, we're going to worship the one that Steve and Morgan are doing that for. His name is Jesus. So I'm going to ask you now to stand to your feet, and we're going to have a little bit of a rehearsal of a moment we're going to have in heaven where people of every tribe and tongue and nation and language are going to stand before the throne of God, and we're going to worship Jesus, our Savior, and hail King Jesus. Let's worship together.
Hello, parents and friends and class of 2023.
It is an honor and a privilege to get to lead worship for you one last time. Our God is so worthy of praise, and my prayer over our class is that as we go on all these different paths of life, to different universities, to work, to travel, to serve our country, that we keep our eyes fixed on the Lord and fixed on heaven, and that we can help further the kingdom, and that we just keep pursuing God with a passion. So, with that being said, let's worship together.
Yeah.
Lord, for you deserve the glory. We give you all of our praise, for you deserve our praise, God. We love you because you deserve our love, and you loved us first. For that, we are eternally grateful. And we specifically am so grateful to have had the opportunity to come to a school like CCA, where I had staff and faculty and friends alongside me that brought me closer to the Lord and helped me to build my relationship with him. And if I had one request, God, I just pray that the class of 2023, that we are not conformed to the patterns of this world, God, but we are transformed by the renewing of our minds to prove what is that good, perfect, and acceptable will of God. And even though this new chapter may bring fear, God, we know that if the God of the universe is for us, who can be against us? So there's nothing to fear, for you are on our side and you are for us, God. May we present our bodies as living sacrifices for you, God. May we devote our lives to you, and that all we do glorifies your name, God. We love you so much, and we worship you, and we thank you for bringing us here and what you will continue to do in our lives. We love you so much, and in your name we pray. Amen.
You may be seated. Can we give another hand for worship? That was amazing. Well, good evening. It's truly an honor to be here with you this evening and have the privilege to address the esteemed and remarkable graduating class of 2023. I would like to recognize Pastor Doug Souter and Dr. Jason Rachels, our CCA faculty and staff, parents, extended families, loved ones, and friends, because without you, this night would not be possible. Seniors, as we congratulate you, but we also celebrate the wonderful individuality that you display, we're excited because in all the endeavors you have chosen to undertake, you have honored him. See, in this class are scientists and mentors, dancers, biblical scholars, programmers, actors, athletes, filmmakers, and the list goes on, and we commend you for all that you have achieved. There was some trepidation on my part as I prepared for this commencement address, I must say. I was worried that I wouldn't be able to think of anything to say, and then my son reminded me, "Dad, you're a pastor. They always just keep talking." I didn't feel qualified to speak. I didn't graduate with accolades or honors like many of the seniors before you just stood with a 4-point, some ridiculous number that I would never hit. And even as I spoke to a CCA alum on Wednesday afternoon, she told me that she graduated summa cum laude. And I said, during my ceremony, they just sang Kumbaya Lord, we hope he makes it. But here I am. I was worried that you may not like the content until one of the graduating seniors of this class finally put me at ease, and she said, and I quote, "Don't worry, Mr. Mayo, there will be so much happening that no one will probably remember what you have to say anyway." Gets better. Plus, this is your last year, so, and I quote, "It's all good." I'm thankful that it's all good, and hopefully you remember at least a little bit of what I have to share graduating seniors tonight. But before we do anything else, let's just go to the Lord in prayer one more time. So God, we are thankful for a night like this. Lord, we're thankful for CCA, and we're thankful for all that you have accomplished and all that you have done. And when we look back, we can't help but do just that and thank you and praise you. And so, Lord, for this graduating class, we're excited. In a minute, they're going to walk across the stage, and Lord, that'll be just another celebration, but it'll also be the beginning for them. So, Lord, bless them even now as they prepare to celebrate, but they also prepare to go soon. And Lord, make the way before them, and you go before them. We pray all these things in your name, amen. For years, I was a social science teacher. And I remember that Woodrow Wilson at one time, he made an address, and after his address, during his address, he had 14 points. And after his address, the French prime minister said, "Even God Almighty only had 10. So I figured tonight I would be safe if I kept it to just 3. Seniors, my encouragement tonight doesn't come with a fancy title. It's really just three phrases that, despite all that is going on tonight, I hope you remember. And the first bit of encouragement I have for you graduating seniors is this phrase, and it's just this: enjoy the journey. Enjoy the journey. See, this encouragement is not a new one. It's come in many forms. It has been said, the journey is the destination. Focus on the journey, not the destination. Joy is found not in finishing an activity, but doing it. T.S. Eliot would tell you that it's the journey, not the arrival, that matters. Others would simply say it's not the mountaintop, it's the climb. Now, if you're getting nervous that I'm about to play a Miley Cyrus song, relax. I would not do that to you seniors at your graduation or ever. But what I would say is, in a moment, you'll walk across the stage and receive a diploma to loud cheering and air horns and cowbells. Parents, I know you have them. And big signs. But what made that possible was the time that you spent with your friends, the time in late nights, the early mornings, the books that you read, the presentations that you put together and developed, the papers that you wrote, the practice, the rehearsal. And this is an amazing moment for you. But I hope you enjoyed the journey. See, it's easy in our tweet-happy, technology-driven, soundbite-obsessed Insta culture for you to think that success should come just as quickly as everything else that you access. But listen, even in your parents' day, there were earth-shattering technological advancements such as 8-track tapes, cordless phones, and my personal favorite, dial-up internet. But I bet if you would talk to your parents, they would tell you that even back then, there was a pressure to focus on only the achievement, only the accomplishment, only the moment. But the journey is what life is made up of. The world's most successful people will tell you they truly enjoy the process and the work just as much or even more than the achievement. See, a New York Times bestselling author put it this way: finishing a book for me is rewarding, but the most exhilarating feeling I get is entering the process of a new work. I enjoy the journey of editing, creating, revising. In the work is where I find joy. The owner of a very popular restaurant that many of our graduating seniors work at said, the day today brings the most joy for me. In daily activity is where I find the people I can help, the good I can do, the lives that can be changed. Many people focus on the success of our company, but I am most proud of the journey that we took to get here and the journey we will continue to go on. See, many of those who have long since retired look back and realize what they truly love wasn't necessarily getting there, but everything that they experienced and encountered along the way. It's easy to focus on the time of honoring, and in life, maybe you will receive a few short hours of recognition and celebration, much like we're doing here tonight. And maybe if you're lucky later in life, a day or two of recognition and celebration. But before you realize it, the moment is over. It's back to the process. It's back to the work. It's back to the journey. So seniors, enjoy the journey. The second phrase I have for you tonight is simply this: rise to the occasion. Rise to the occasion. See, the reason that you've been prepared spiritually, academically, and socially is not so we can look good when we say it at events and school functions. See, you've been prepared for all the situations that the Lord will set before you and to meet the challenge that each one brings. There are countless biblical examples, it seems, of those who have risen to the occasion. Hebrew boys in captivity in a foreign land. A young man who was a dreamer and then a slave and then a ruler. A sheep herder who was chosen to be a king. A young couple on their way to Bethlehem. And just like you, all those people were teenagers. See, this will not be an easy thing to do. It will require strength, courage, perseverance, and most of all, a devoted faith. My hope is that you have been prepared counter to the culture that you are about to enter in. And after tonight, we'll be more deeply sent into. See, you're going into a culture where many people love certainty so much, they are not content so much that they are content not to be challenged. You're going into a culture where people believe things should be given to them and not earned. You're going into a culture where people desire comfort instead of facing adversity, even when there is the possibility that greatness can be achieved. This is not new, because even God's chosen people, when told the details of the promised land that awaited them, chose not to confront the adversity that needed to be dealt with in order to enter into the promised land. So I encourage you, class of 2023, fight those feelings, because rarely is something significant ever accomplished without resistance. Rarely is something significant ever accomplished without struggle. So often you hear encouragements from us, encouragements that say things like, reach for the stars, or we will say encouragements like, fly high. Even your first event to kick off this school year, if you remember, was called Senior Soar. But even airplanes, which seem to move easily from the runway into the sky, actually need a certain amount of resistance against them to properly rise. It has been noted that most aircraft take off against the wind with a high amount of resistance, actually sometimes the higher the better, in order for them to generate more lift and thus fly higher and thus rise greater. It's an easy thing when faced with a challenge to cater to feelings of reluctancy, feelings of doubt. But you were encouraged last night, and I remind you again, trust in what you know and trust in the Lord. Many of us are familiar with the famous quote that states, our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. We've heard that one many times. My favorite comes from Nelson Mandela, who puts it like this. He says, there's no passion to be found playing small, settling for a life that is less than the one you are capable of living. So class of 2023, I encourage you, rise to meet the challenge ahead. Rise when life knocks you down. Rise when it's 5 a.m. and you don't feel like it. Rise when everyone around you is looking for someone to take a stand against injustice. Rise to the occasion, because it's in that moment that you will point to his glory, always remembering that it's in his strength that you rise, because he rose for you. And before I leave you with my final phrase, graduates, I'll say probably to you for the last time, let me see everybody's eyes. Remember who you represent. Remember who you represent. See, in 2 Corinthians 5:20 and 21, it says this, we are therefore Christ's ambassadors. As though God were making his appeal through us, we implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. For he made him who knew no sin to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in him. See, the Greek word for ambassador is presbyomen. It means a representative who bears responsibility. And seniors, just as an ambassador bears responsibility, we also bear responsibility. So let me leave you with this phrase, don't let talent take you where character can't keep you. An ambassador carried a message for the king to a foreign land, and that message was important because it came from the king. But wherever you go, whatever vocation you choose, whatever God puts in front of you, your life will carry an important message to others that's from the king. As an ambassador, how people ultimately reacted did not depend on them. They were just supposed to carry the message and deliver it well. In ancient times, the Spartans threw the Persian ambassadors into the deepest well that they had. That's not a prophecy over any of you. People may not react favorably to the gospel message that you carry, and you may face strong opposition along the way, but your job will be to carry it and deliver it well. I was recently asked by a parent of one of our graduating seniors, Mr. Mayo, graduation is almost here. Do you think they are ready? I replied, they're absolutely ready. I know that you all are ready because representing him of what you have been doing for a really, really long time now. And we have watched Jesus make an appeal to others through you on the stage, on the athletic field, using a robot, in a school, in a foreign country. You were an ambassador of Jesus Christ. Parents, maybe your son or daughter told you, but the other night we all sat on a green and listened to this class. They shared their experiences about how they've grown, shared their experiences about their time here and what the future might hold, and they acknowledged the friendships that they had and how they have grown closer as a class. Some of them shared how they went through some very tough times, but they came out better for it at the end. Well, class of 2023, now it's time to spread your wings just a little bit wider and go into something that you may not know, but just know that Jesus goes with you. I have a friend who has a very simple saying, but I remember it almost daily. He says, if you love him, then you should represent him well. So at your workplace, in your future classes, in your dorm room, with your friends, in this country or another, whether you are in front of 100 people or whether you are in front of just one, remember who you represent. To the class of 2023, congratulations. You have made us all very, very proud. And we have been together for a long time, and you know how I like to open and close. So I leave you with this. There are no goodbyes. We just open another chapter. If I don't see you in this life, eternity comes after. We love to stay here forever, but we know our time is passing. Don't be a baby about it, like playing senior assassin. So no more infractions, no more chasing you on a golf cart. But I hope you realize we tried to love you with our whole heart. If one thing could be said, this phrase would most please us. The class of 2023 walks with Jesus.
Thank you, Pastor Mayo, our friend and our leader for these last many years. Your life, your example, and your legacy will never leave this place and will impact and carry these students. And now, Ms. Fox and I get to do the job you've done so well for the last many years. Class of 2023, these are the words you've been waiting for. It is now time for the conferring of diplomas. So you've made it, and your time is here, and we are going to spend the next few minutes watching you walk across the stage.
Class of 2023, we leave you with a strong and robust well done, an encouragement to continue to seek a strong foundation in Christ and keep him first. As two of your teachers and administrators, it has been our privilege to serve you and to watch you love and serve others.
And so we begin. Daniel Joshua Cuesta. Daniel will be attending the University of Notre Dame. Thomas George Poulos. Will be attending Liberty University. Cole Thomas Baird. Will be attending the U.S. Air Force Academy Preparatory School. Kamara Julie Thermidor. Will be attending the University of Florida. Gianna Isabella Biggio. will be attending Liberty University. Elizabeth Anid Gallardo Tirado, Florida State University. Isabella Grace Leon, Florida International University. Daniel Alexander Lopez will be attending Florida Gulf Coast University. Vanessa Alexandra Miro will be attending Nova Southeastern University. Lauren Adalis Murray will be attending Andrews University. Dana Faith Ridgely will be attending Palm Beach Atlantic University. Brianna Morgan Tully will be attending the University of South Florida. Ava McCall Underwood will be attending the University of Mississippi. Mario Awed will be attending the University of Florida. Mm-hmm. Ana Sofia Alegria will be attending Florida Gulf Coast University. Isabel Grace Aluart will be attending the University of Florida. Tyler Lewis Abate Cooper Brad Aurelia will be attending Stetson University. Caleb Michael Barnes will be attending the University of Florida. Grayson Charles Bartholomew will be attending the Universal Technical Institute. Grace Ann Barley will be attending Nova Southeastern University. Nicole Bello will be attending the Latin University of Costa Rica. Brianne Ariel Bent will be attending Florida Atlantic University. Bradley Ray Bethiram Matthew Douglas Blackwood will be attending the Coral Springs Fire Academy. Sage Cameron Boyce will be attending Florida Atlantic University. Christopher Broglin will be attending Tennessee State University. Zach William Boland will be attending Daytona State University. Xavier Grant Bumbaro will be attending the University of Miami. And Isaiah Timothy Boynton will be joining YWAM Youth with a Mission. Luca Samuel Braswell U.S. Marine Corps enlistment. Mm-hmm. Tyler Christian Broderson will be attending Broward College. Emily Bianca Brown. Isabella Victoria Butrago will be attending Florida Atlantic University. Tiona Amari Bush will be attending Albany State University. Callie Marie Caffaro. Will be attending the University of South Florida. Kelsey Kroll. Kelsey will be attending Broward College. Ava Heather Camargo will be attending Alfred University. Tristan Don Campbell will be attending Florida State University. Mm-hmm. Guillem Arme Cardonas Matos Daniela Carrero will be attending Nova Southeastern University. Kyle Andrew Carter will be attending Palm Beach State College. Ian Kyle Carvajal will be attending Liberty University. Valentina Casale will be attending the University of Central Florida. Ryan Cavalencia will be attending Florida State University. Danny Champion will be attending the University of Central Florida. Emma Christian Chapin Rebecca Ruth Charleska will be attending Broward College. Carl Henry Scherenfond will be attending the University of Memphis. Andrew Raymond Christ will be attending Florida Atlantic University. Ryan Matthew Churchill will be attending Broward College.
Savannah Tenquery Clark will be attending the University of South Florida. Katie Bridget Clausen will be attending Covenant College. Caleb John Coble will be attending
Florida International University. Devon Gianni Cole will be attending Broward College. Kevin Dario Calindris. Dylan Michael Moser Courage will be attending Broward College. Justice Grant Courage Croak will be attending the University of South Florida. Lily Montgomery Croak will be attending the University of South Florida Honors College. Chase Mark Cubarubia will be attending the University of Central Florida. Eric Delman Cummings II will be attending Broward College. Dylan Joseph DiAugustino will be attending Auburn University Honors College. Maya R. Darva will be attending Florida A&M University. Isaac Andrew Da Silva. Sarah Michelle Dawson will be attending Florida Atlantic University. Luis Esteban De La Cruz Rodriguez will be attending Florida Southern College. Raquel Suzette De La Cruz Rodriguez will be attending the University of South Florida. Charles Albert De Oliveira Sieber will be attending Broward College. Madison Alexandria Dia, who will be attending Palm Beach State College. Ashley Danae Olivia Douglas, who will be attending Florida International University. Jalen Trinity Dudley, who will be attending the University of South Florida. Anaya Callie Edmead, who will be attending the University of Central Florida. Gage Henry Eller, who will be attending Palm Beach, Atlantic University. Faith Angel Elwell, who will be attending the University of Florida. Soleil Vera Escobar, who will be attending the University of South Florida. Joshua Brandon Espinoza, who will be attending Palm Beach Atlantic University. Andrea Valentina Ferreira, who will be attending the University of Central Florida. Sophie Angela Ferro Santa Cruz, who will be attending Florida Atlantic University. Laura Ashley Fontanez Alvarado, who will be attending Florida International University. Hillary Elizabeth Foster, who will be attending the University of Alabama Honors College. Paul Bricks Fountain, who will be attending Florida Atlantic University. Dylan Garces, Valeria Garcia, who will be attending Florida International University. Hannah Day Gary, who will be attending the University of Central Florida. Kelly Grace Goenaga, who will be attending Florida International University Honors College. Francesca Gonzalez, who will be attending Broward College. Jessica Faith Hansen, who will be attending the University of Alabama. Benjamin William Harbin, who will be attending Florida Atlantic University. Allie Elizabeth Harrison, who will be attending the University of South Florida. Parker William Hatcher, Jacob Hunter Haynes, who will be attending Towson University. Michael Scott Heckman, who will be attending Florida Atlantic University. Katarina Victoria Hernandez, who will be attending the University of Central Florida. Sean Alexander Hickman, who will be attending Broward College. Charlie Rose Hicks, who will be attending Florida Gulf Coast University. Zishuan Crystal Huang, Alec Anthony Ingersoll, who will be attending the Coral Springs Fire Academy. Lucas Noah Jones, who will be attending the University of North Florida. David Jaden Joseph, who will be attending Nova Southeastern University. Isabella Lucia Josh, who will be attending Broward College.
Lena Chantal Juby will be attending Nova Southeastern University. Kelsey Grace Keller, will be attending Florida Atlantic University. Sophia Helena Kerrigan, Florida Gulf Coast University. Emma Brooke Kohlhepp will be attending Broward College. Daniel Lewis LaBoy will be attending the University of Central Florida. Sophia Rose Lagasse will be attending Florida Atlantic University. Trent James LaRuffa will be attending Broward College. Catherine Elizabeth Lawrence will be attending the University of South Florida. Nevaeh Christiana Lawrence will be attending the University of South Florida. Natalie A. Leva will be attending Broward College. Janelia Natassian Lodge will be attending Florida International University. Franco Lupica Tondo will be attending Florida International University. Azana Faith Mack. Will be attending Wheaton College. Leah Catherine Mansour will be attending Louisiana State University. Emily Renee Maragos will be attending Florida Atlantic University. Miguel Alberto Marcon will be attending Palm Beach Atlantic University. Ashlyn Rachel Marjama will be attending Dort University. Brooke Lauren Marjama will be attending Dort University. Dylan Paul Mascarenas Sarah Elizabeth Matzett will be attending Santa Fe College. Dakeen Allen Nayard Taylor McMullen will be attending the University of Florida. Jaden Love Malilling will be attending Liberty University. David Earl Metzger will be attending the University of New Orleans. Lucas Daniel Milkey will be attending Florida Atlantic University. Sophia Elizabeth Mileto will be attending Liberty University. Kaya Faith Mills will be attending Taylor University. Joshua Nathaniel Minot will be attending Palm Beach State College. Caleb Jaden Mitchell will be attending Auburn University at Montgomery. Braylon Avery Mittauer will be attending Lake Sumner State College. Janine Annabella Monnier Joy Cardoso Montiero will be attending Broward College. Naya Marie Montez will be attending Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University. Alexa Lynn Montoya will be attending Palm Beach State College. Daniela Moran will be attending Florida Atlantic University. Santiago Muscoto will be attending Florida International University. Evangeline Rosa Nahala will be attending Florida Atlantic University Wilkes Honors College. Amanda Victoria Natt will be attending Clemson University. Emily Navarro will be attending Furman University. Martina Nicole Noya will be attending Florida International University. Jonah Ray Nelson will be attending Florida International University. Mark A. Newman will be attending Valencia College. Orpha Noel will be attending the University of Central Florida. Leah Giselle Atanat will be attending Jacksonville University. Andrew Dean Palacios Jacob Allen Posh will be attending the University of Central Florida. Kiara Ivanka Patterson will be attending Florida International University. Jack Burton Perez will be attending the Savannah College of Art and Design.
Morgan Isabel Perez will be attending Florida Atlantic University. Rulon Kai Pearson Rianne Marie Pearson, who will be attending Florida A&M University. Joshua Piashikan, who will be attending the Tri-County Technical College. William Maddox Pinchek, who will be attending the University of South Florida. Eva Savitri Polio, who will be attending the University of South Florida. Stella Giselle Pozo, who will be attending Broward College. Jose Alfredo Prieto, who will be attending the University of Central Florida. Zoe Louise Perdick, who will be attending the University of Florida. Alice Rani, Renita Hope Rajkumar, who will be attending the University of Maryland. Ashton James Redman, who will be attending Liberty University. Luke Isaiah Richardson, who will be attending Broward College. Jose Fernando Rodriguez, who will be attending the University of South Florida. Juan Pablo Segundo Romero Colmenares,
who will be attending Santa Fe College. Franco Thomas Giuseppe Rocco, who will be attending Bowdoin College. Brooke Nicole Salerno, who will be attending the University of South Carolina, Aiken. Caitlin Sanchez, who will be attending Palm Beach State College. Kingston Sorrell, Adam Robert Severese, who will be attending Broward College. Anna Claire Yuching Schwartz. Ivana Alexis Schwert, who will be attending Florida Atlantic University. Sophia Amarim Silva, who will be attending the University of Central Florida. Angelica Victoria Soares, who will be attending Palm Beach State College. Tyler Ian Stoller, who will be attending the University of South Florida. Dylan Gabriel Stapp, who will be attending Broward College. Landon Joshua Still, who will be attending Liberty University. James Michael Stone, who will be attending the University of Central Florida. Gabriel Alexander Streich, who will be attending the University of Central Florida. Celeste Rose Stressaw, who will be attending Florida State University. Joseph Anthony Studiali, who will be attending Belmont University. Attila Alexander Sathmayer, Caden Angelina Talbert, who will be attending the University of Central Florida. Alejandra Tavares Mihangos, who will be attending Southeastern University. Zoe Grace Tibbs, who will be attending Florida Southern College. Melanie Nicole Torres, who will be attending the University of Miami. Julio Alejandro Trabanino, who will be attending Broward College. Anthony John Truglia, who will be attending Florida Gulf Coast University. Mariana Lucia Arutia, who will be attending the University of South Florida. Trinity Faith Van Devender, who will be attending the University of Florida Honors College. Peter Andrew Vargas, who will be attending Broward College. Ashlyn Faith Vick, who will be attending the University of Florida. Nicholas Villacorta, who will be attending the University of Florida. Joshua Hoshea Wallace, Jacob Anthony Warren, who will be attending Fairleigh Dickinson University.
Danielle K. Wendorf, who will be attending Florida Gulf Coast University. Sarah Frances Wiley, who will be attending Barry University. Jacob Harrison Williams, who will be attending Florida Gulf Coast University. Wayan Frank Shu, who will be attending the University of Florida. Luca Elena Zito, who will be attending Florida Atlantic University.
We'll just wait a few moments for some photos to be taken. As we do, it's a fun moment to be at this place where seniors, you're on the precipice of what's next. Congratulations again, getting to this place. Where diplomas are in your hand, or at least the case for them, and we're proud of you for getting to that. Well done. We're excited about what God has next for you. So much shows in getting that, the work that you've done, the way by which you've operated and navigated what's been at CCA or other places leading up till now. And we're excited for what you're going to do for the kingdom when it comes to this next season. I can filibuster a little bit longer, or we can just stay here and watch as the last few pictures get taken. All right. There's more. But wait. There's more. While we're waiting, they're going to join you. So graduates who are sitting, would you please rise now? So, on behalf of the faculty and staff, so too I believe your parents, we just want to tell you, we love you. We are so proud of you. And here, you have now done it. Congratulations. With that being said, it's my great pleasure that I announce to you, audience, that these students standing in front of me have successfully completed the spiritual, the academic, and social requirements necessary for graduation from Calvary Christian Academy. Graduates, I now confer upon you your high school degree. Congratulations. You may move your tassel from the right to the left as you have graduated. May God bless you and keep you as you go forth and make disciples. Family, friends, it's my honor to present to you the Calvary Christian Academy's graduated class of 2023.